welcome to Thursday's edition of The Voice of Resurrection Devotional. Tithing. Should we tithe in this dispensation? Is it an old covenant thing? We have established that Abraham gave tithes to Melchizedek. And I want to read from Galatians 3 once again to show you the absurdity of those assertions that tithing is an Old Testament concept. He said, brethren, Galatians 3:15, I speak after the manner of men, though it be but a man's covenant, yet if it be confirmed, no man disannul it or added thereunto. So, the Bible says, if God enters into a covenant with a man, no power can disannul that covenant, even though it is done with a man. Now, to Abraham and his seed where the promise is made, he said not unto seeds as of many, but as of one, and to thy seed, which is Christ. See? So when God made promise to Abraham, he was promising, making those promises to his seed, not Isaac and Jacob. He said it was Christ, through whom we will receive everything. And he told you that's why Jesus became a curse, so that we will receive the blessed. Why do you want to go back to the curse? Listen, it says, and this I say, that the covenant that was confirmed before of God in Christ, the covenant that was confirmed before of God in Christ, you notice, this is a covenant, it's not a law, it's not any of this stuff, it's heart, it's God entering into covenant with a man to bless him. And the amazing thing about the Abrahamic covenant is that God guarantees both sides. You don't depend on me. It's him carrying everything. That's the amazing thing. You don't know what you're forfeiting. Listen carefully. He says, and this I say, that the covenant that was confirmed before of God in Christ, the law, which was 430 years after, cannot disannul. He said that what we received happened 430 years before the law came. And the law has no power to abrogate it. The law doesn't even enter into that realm. The law is way beneath the covenant of Abraham. For if the inheritance be of the law, it is no more of promise. But God gave it to Abraham by promise. By promise, beloved, not by the law. He entered into this covenant. He received the blessing. He tithed. That's where we belong, beloved. We have no inheritance in Moses. We are sons of Abraham. That's what you got to learn. Maybe next week I'll cover that difference on one day, trusting that God will open our eyes and help us to grab this blessing and never let it go and never allow the naysayers and all these venom-filled people filled with devils, I dare say, I'm sorry, you know? Because when you listen to the vehemence of their speech and the cutting comments and the dishonor, you know, they say, you know that is not the Spirit of God. And then you have all the so-called heretic hunters. Listen carefully. God gave this to Abraham by promise. He started tithing based on his covenant with God. Melchizedek taught him that. It's not a commandment. It's a covenant. It's a heart. It's a heart. It's an amazing thing. And then we will see why tithing was brought into the law. Because that's how you serve God. But it didn't originate in the law. That's what I've never been able to understand. Why people keep making noise. It's the Old Testament, is the law. Tithing did not originate in the law. It was already here before the law was given. 430 years later. And the Bible tells you clearly it cannot disannul what was here before it came. Are you a son of Abraham? Or are you a son of Moses? Choose Abraham. Choose tithing. Your life will not remain the same. You will enjoy the blessing some of us have experienced. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.